In this tutorial, we'll show you how to manage time periods in strategic modeling. When you create a model, the model is populated with a hierarchical chart of accounts, a time structure, reports, data views, account groups, and all the metadata from the template or the model it was created from. The model's time structure can be defined based on different levels of granularity for different years. For example, you can set the years toward the end of your forecast period to show only annual values, while years within a 5-year forecast can be set to show more granular details such as quarterly or monthly. After creating your model, you can modify time period structure and settings. The time period options in the Actions menu allow you to perform time management tasks. You can create deal periods in which the balance sheet is restated to reflect merger and acquisition activities. A deal period is a 0-day period that is used for transaction analysis. View Properties displays the model's smallest time periods available, the calendar type, the number of months per year, and what month the fiscal year ends. You can change which month the fiscal year ends and the last actual period. You can also select to use the current scenario's data for that period. Manage details is where you make changes to time period details. You can add or delete years from the beginning or end of financial model timelines and set the last historical period, number of years to use for historical averages, and the base period. All years have yearly selected by default. For any year other than the beginning balance year, you can select and combine periods of years, halves, quarters, months, and weeks for historical and forecast data. When you apply your changes, you can select whether to calculate inputs for all scenarios, only for the current scenario, or not to calculate any inputs. Calculated data is displayed based on updated time periods. Each period, other than the beginning balance year, allows for additional customization in settings. Define sub-periods for periods when transactions such as acquisitions or leveraged buyouts occur. For example, for a leveraged buyout that took place on April 15, the sub-period length is 105 days. Create more sub-periods and allocate days until unallocated days is zero. Data for 2018, including the new sub-periods, were calculated for the current scenario. To allow for transaction analysis of the buyout, I'll add a deal period and attach it to the sub-period. By adding deal periods, you can simulate the effects that mergers, acquisitions, or divestitures have on the organization based on the timing of the transactions. When you insert a deal period, the original period is split into 3 periods: closing, deal, and a calculated total of the two. The closing period contains the data from the original input time period. The deal period is an additional input column strictly for recording deal information. Trailing periods are time periods that collect the most recent number of time periods. You can set up trailing periods to occur in either a historical or a forecast period. With trailing time periods, you can measure business performance over a specific time duration. Use period-to-date to create year-to-date, half-year-to-date, quarter-to-date, or month-to-date periods. All financial accounts in period-to-date periods are calculated by default. You can view period-to-date periods in the account spreadsheet or in reports. Click Cancel if you don't want to accept any changes. You can change or remove time period details by clearing selections in the Details section. You can delete trailing time periods or sub-periods anytime. In this tutorial, you saw how to manage time periods in strategic modeling. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.